Joining us right now is the BuzzFeed editor-in-chief, Ben Smith. Ben, good to have you on. Can you explain, first of all, your response right now to what Special Counsel Mueller's office has released?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for having me on. We, you know, obviously we stand by the reporting in this story. We spoke to, as we described, to federal law enforcement officials involved in the investigation. We're not playing any games with that characterization. Who told us that the president directed Michael Cohen to lie to Congress?
Do you know who those two sources are? Because I know you're this was
two
reporters.
Yeah, of course I know.
Okay.
Yes. You know, and we've been reporting on the Trump Tower Moscow, which is at the heart of the Russia investigation, for months. We broke stories about it before it was at the center of the Cohen indictment, and that was these Jason Leopold and Anthony Cormier. We hope that the special counsel released this vague statement disputing the piece, and we really urge the special counsel to make it clear what he's disputing.
When you say it's a vague statement, and I just want to read for our viewers what the special counsel has said. They said BuzzFeed's description of specific statements to the special counsel's office and characterization of documents and testimony obtained by this office regarding Michael Cohen's congressional testimony are not accurate. As we were pointing out earlier in the program, it's wrong to characterize this as knocking down the story entirely. But there's certainly, I mean, it's a very specifically worded statement from them.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, they're obviously some of the best lawyers in America, and they are clearly referring to something, and we hope that they will tell us what they are referring to. I mean, I think at this point, we would hope that they would clarify that.
But you know it is highly unlikely that they would clarify a statement that, I mean, took them, you know, some 20 or so hours to come out with. Are you actually expecting them to make another statement to clarify? Because, you know, pre-Barrera earlier, we're saying that's highly unlikely.
I mean, I think that would be the responsible thing for them to do. Yes.
Do you have any belief that...
We and everybody else are continuing to report on this, and so I'm hopeful that, you know, more of the facts will come out regardless. But, yeah, we think you... But, yes, they've issued this statement that makes clear that they're disputing something in the story and does not say what.
Do you have any doubts at this point about the story, about what you have reported? I know you're saying you're stand by it. Are there specific areas you have doubts about, or any doubts?
We're really confident in these specific sources and in the story the reporters told.
Ben, I think Brian Stelter has a question for you.
Ben, earlier today, the Republican National Committee challenged one of the two reporters, Jason Leopold, said he has a history of false reporting. I know he's had a great track record for you, working for you, but are you concerned at all about the histories of your reporters being questioned and their work being questioned?
You know, thanks for the question, Brian. I mean, I think that, you know, when we saw the Republican National Committee others launching ad hominem attacks and the reporters in this story, that struck us as that's something you typically do when you don't have a better response. And we did not see the kind of strong and detailed denials or anything like them that you might have expected. Instead, we saw ad hominem attacks on Jason, you know, who was a Pulitzer finalist 2 years ago for reporting on a series of assassinations in Russia, who's one of, you know, who's the leading practitioner of FOIA in the United States, and whose work included revealing Hillary Clinton's emails. I think it's ludicrous to go back and, you know, dredge around the stuff that, you know, stories from 15 years ago that are absolutely, you know, real and that he wrote about back then.
Right, but people wonder sometimes if they're in this partisan polarized age, if anti-Trump bias or reporters' own opinions creep into the coverage. In something like this, you might hear something from a source and you want it to be true. Did that happen, you think, in this case?
No, absolutely not. And the last time Jason was being accused of things like this, it was when his reporting revealed Hillary Clinton's emails, and it was coming from the other side.
Ben, it's Jeff Toobin here. Is it unnerving to you that so many other reporters are chasing this story and no one has come up with anything like what you have come up with?
I'm not sure I know that to be true, but certainly everybody's chasing this, and everybody's chasing it carefully and trying to confirm it. We'll, I assume, see over the next couple of days where our reporting and where everybody else's reporting advances it.
I mean, we all love to have scoops, but isn't it nervous-making that you're out there by yourself on a story that lots and lots of very good reporters are covering?
The specifics of this story grew out of a story that we've been out way out in front exclusively on, which is the Moscow Project, which is a somewhat different line of inquiry. And Jason and Anthony have been through this whole process at times pretty far out on somewhat separate lines of inquiry than everybody else. But obviously, the facts are true or they're false, and we will all get to the bottom of this. I think the special counsel could immediately make clear what in the story he's disputing that would make it easier for everybody to stand it up. But we are very confident in the reporting.
Hey, Ben, it's Preet Bharara taking my shot at a question, too. Do you have a complaint with respect to the special counsel in the following respect? And if you can say, maybe you can't say, but usually and often, at least, with respect to these kinds of articles, you would have said to the special counsel's office in advance of the publication of the article, we plan to report the following, that the President of the United States directed Michael Cohen to lie to Congress. What do you think about that? And some offices will wave you off if they think it's outrageous and mischaracterizes the facts beforehand, or you work it out in a way that's appropriate for both the media institution and also the special counsel's office. Or maybe they're the type that never respond to any kind of inquiry ever, and then 20 hours after you issue the story, they put out this statement. Do you have any complaint with respect to how this came out in that respect?
I think it probably wouldn't be appropriate for me to say whether one office or the other has a habit of waving people off and waving people on. I do think what they did here is just extremely confusing.
Confusing in what way?
To all of us. I mean, confusing in that it's not clear that, a day after a story is published, they come out with this very detailed and very opaque statement disputing it.
Are you concerned? Frankly, I'm concerned that when you, over the next few months, whenever there's a hot story, a big scoop that comes out, you're going to hear from the president and his supporters, oh, it's another BuzzFeed story. It's another story like BuzzFeed where, even Robert Mueller said it was false. Do you worry that that's going to damage all of us?
I mean, we are, like I think most of our colleagues, very focused on doing the reporting and getting it right, and that's pretty much all we can do.
So now, right now, you have reporters out there trying to, go back to sources, follow up on this? I assume you have everybody trying to follow up on this.
Yes, absolutely.
Ben Smith, I appreciate you talking to you.
Thank you
very much.
Yeah.
Rudy Giuliani has just tweeted, I commend Bob Mueller's office for correcting the BuzzFeed false story that President Trump encouraged Cohen to lie. I ask the press to take heed that their hysterical desire to destroy this president has gone too far. They pursued this without critical analysis all day.
Oh, that's helpful. Sorry for the sarcasm. I think the former mayor of New York is increasingly acting as an extension of the president, and I think that that is, as opposed to just sort of presenting a legal defense, and I think that was what you saw with that statement, and I think that it just adds to fuel to the fire, frankly, because there's going to be a lot of criticism from the president, and it's understandable. I mean, given the special counsel statement and given the fact that none of us have, as of yet, corroborated the BuzzFeed story, it's not surprising that the president's team would do this.
Do you read into the fact that the president, as far as the last tweets we saw or I saw, is not actually tweeting himself, that he's just kind of retweeting thing, that he's not going on the record?
I'm sure that he will tomorrow.
Right.
I think what he's just trying to do is show that other people are criticizing and it's not just him. I mean, what we have increasingly seen from this president is that he is serving as and we often say this, he's serving as his own chief of staff, his own this, his own that. I mean, but he really is driving his own message, and I think that you're seeing that very much today. You're looking at a White House that is dealing with the longest government shutdown in history, and this gives them something to point to that is not about that. So I would very much expect them to be talking about it. But look, it is generally speaking, in the course of the Mueller story, the opposite has been true. Something has been reported. You have had the White House deny it, and then it has proven to be true. This is an unusual case. And to be clear, Mueller's team, as we said before, did not say the story is false.
Right.
They said it's inaccurate, as that is described, and we don't know specifically what they're referring to. But this is the rare instance where that has happened, and I'm not surprised that they're pointing to it this way.